It's time for another episode of the Faith Fight Podcast. Today we're talking about praying using the Word of God. Hello again, everybody. Thank you for tuning into this episode of the Faith Fight Podcast. I'm your host, Chris Creary, and I'm here to help you get your prayers answered, to encourage you to grow from glory to glory, and to ultimately assist you in achieving your God-given purpose. Thank you for tuning in today, and I hope that this episode blesses you, and I hope that all is well with you. To all of my first-time listeners, thank you for tuning in. I want to let you know that the podcast is available on all of the major podcasts and apps. It's on Apple Podcasts, Google Podcasts, Spotify, Amazon Music, and on Audible. So if you listen to podcasts using any of those apps, all you need to do is search the Faith Fight Podcast, and you'll be able to find this podcast and subscribe so that you can get every future episode that I release on a Monday morning when I release them. And also, I want to let you know that the podcast is also on YouTube, so you can find it there as well. And in addition to getting every future episode, I also have an archive of over 200 episodes that I've done over the past 4.5 years. So if you are going through any situations and you need encouraging Bible verses or for someone to stand in agreement in prayer concerning the situation that you are going through, go into the archives and scroll through the different topics, and you can download and listen to any one of those past episodes. I will go over the Bible verses so that they can encourage you, so that you can know what the Word of God says about that specific situation, and I'll explain what those verses mean. And at the end of every episode, I always pray, so I come in agreement with you concerning that specific topic. So there's a link in the description of this episode for all of the podcast directories, and also there's a link to get into the archives so that you can click on those links and go to any one of those places so that the Faith Fight Podcast can bless you. And that's why I'm doing this podcast, so that it can be a blessing to you. And for those of you coming back again, thank you for joining in. If you've listened to the podcast in the past, and if you know somebody that would be blessed by either something that I did in the past or this episode, share it with them. Take the link from this episode and copy it and paste it into a text message or a WhatsApp group. Share it with your friends. Share the podcast with someone else. You could even listen to one of the episodes and do a group Bible study on one of the topics that I've covered. There are many ways that you can use this podcast to be a blessing to other people. And I would hope and I would like to encourage you to be a blessing to those people around you so that we all can grow and draw closer to God and become who He has called us to be. So if the Faith Fight Podcast blessed you in the past, share it with someone else so that it can bless them as well. Now, I got some really exciting news that I want to share with you guys. It's two things. The first thing is I've just launched my first Christian t-shirt apparel store. Go on to this link that I'm going to share in the description, and you can buy a t-shirt to support the Faith Fight Podcast and boldly declare your faith wherever you go. If you are blessed in the city and blessed in the field, I have a t-shirt for you. If you are forgetting the things that are behind you and if you are pressing forward, I have a t-shirt for you. I've placed links in the description so that you can get to my store and you can buy a t-shirt. So support the podcast by buying a t-shirt for yourself, for a loved one, as a gift, for someone who's graduating, for someone who just got baptized. Maybe you can give them a t-shirt and bless them and encourage them. And I pray that it's a blessing to you. And I thank you for supporting the podcast. Now, the second piece of information that I want to share, which is really exciting, is that I'm working now with individuals or ministries who wish to start their own podcasts. So if you have a call on your life to teach or to speak, or if you have a ministry where you teach every Sunday and you want to start a podcast, I will help you to do that. So I've placed a link in the description of this episode where you can get onto a form and fill out some information so that I can work with you so that we can launch your podcast of your ministry so that you can be a blessing to other people all over the world, just like how the Faith Fight Podcast is a blessing to people all over the world. So if you're a pastor, a teacher, and you teach every single week, and if you want to turn those messages into podcast episodes, click the link in the description and we can work together and start a podcast for your ministry and continue to spread the good news of the gospel to all the ends of the earth. But that's it for the exciting news, but now time to get into this episode, which is just as exciting. Today we're talking about praying using the Word of God. Now last week I explained how to use the Our Father as a prayer template. Now today I'm going to show you how to plug in the Word of God into the Our Father template so that you can pray with power. Now, in order to do this, you have to have the Bible stored in your heart, and as you pray, the Holy Spirit will bring remembrance of those verses to you. I'm going to just show you examples today of how you can plug in the Word of God, but as you pray, you can apply the same principles that I'm going to teach you today so that when you study the Bible and put the verses from the Bible in your heart, you can allow the Holy Spirit to pray through you and pray with power. So let's get into it today. First of all, as I did last week, I'm going to start by reading the Our Father from Matthew chapter 6, verses 9 to 13. It says, "This then is how you should pray. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us today our daily bread, and forgive us our debts as we also have forgiven our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from the evil one." So the first part of this prayer is Our Father in heaven. So you can search your heart and allow the Holy Spirit to speak through you about how God is your heavenly Father. An example of this is Ephesians 4 verse 6. "One God and Father of all, who is over all and through all and in all." Psalm 68 verse 5 says that God is the father to the fatherless and protector of widows is God in his holy habitation. James 1 verse 17 says, "Every good gift and every perfect gift is from above, coming down from the Father of lights, with whom there is no variation or shadow due to change." And 2 Corinthians 6 verse 18 says, "And I will be a father to you, and you shall be sons and daughters to me, says the Lord Almighty." And as you pray these verses, you are acknowledging the intimate relationship that you have with God as your Heavenly Father. So again, this is just an example of how you exalt and praise God for being your Heavenly Father as this part of the Our Father template. Now moving on to the next part is Holy is your name. Now as we move into this part of the prayer, you can call upon the name of the Lord and call it as holy. And here are some Bible verses as an example. Proverbs 18 verse 10 says, "The name of the Lord is a strong tower. The righteous man runs into it and is safe." Acts chapter 4 verse 12 says, "And there is salvation in no one else, for there is no other name under heaven given among men which we must be saved." Psalms 20 verses 7 to 8 says, "Some trust in chariots, some trust in horses, but we trust in the name of the Lord our God. They collapse and fall, but we rise and stand upright." Now in these verses, we see that God's name is holy, exalted, and powerful. There is salvation found in his name, and we can find safety and shelter in his name. We lift up and praise the name of God according to the need that we have in that moment. So exalt his name and call his name because his name is holy and his name is powerful. Now the next part of the Our Father template prayer is "Your kingdom come and your will be done on earth as it is in heaven." So as we pray that God's kingdom comes in our life, we can pray Bible verses that remind us of his sovereignty, and here are some examples. First of all, there's Romans 8 verse 28. It says, "And we know that in all things God works for the good of those who love him, who have been called according to his purpose." Next is Job 42 verse 2, and this is one of my favorite verses. It says, "I know that you can do all things, and that no purpose of yours can be thwarted." And Psalms 103 verse 19 says, "The Lord has established his throne in the heavens, and his kingdom rules over all." And finally, for this part of the template, this verse in Psalms 135, verses 6 and 7 says, "The Lord does whatever pleases him in the heavens and on the earth, in the seas and all their depths. He makes clouds rise from the ends of the earth. He sends lightning with the rain and brings out the wind from his storehouse. And we can literally stay in the book of Psalms and read so many scriptures of God's sovereignty. He works all things for the good. No plan of his can ever be stopped. And he rules on his throne in heaven and does whatever he pleases in heaven and in the earth. So this is how we should pray God's kingdom come and his will be done on earth. The next part of the Our Father template says, "Give us today our daily bread." So this is where we pray for what we need to survive. You can find Bible verses about the specific situation that you are going through and pray them at this part of the Our Father prayer. So here are some examples. Psalms 37 verses 4 to 5 says, "Take delight in the Lord and he will give you the desires of your heart. Commit everything you do to the Lord. Trust him and he will help you." Matthew 7 verses 7 to 8 says, "Keep on asking and you will receive what you ask for. Keep on seeking and you will find. Keep on knocking and the door will be opened to you. For everyone who asks receives, everyone who seeks finds, and to everyone who knocks the door will be opened." And finally, Matthew 6 verse 33 says, "Seek the kingdom of God above all else and live righteously, and he will give you everything you need." So we can pray these verses and mention the specific needs that we have during this part of the Our Father prayer and use Bible verses that align with your specific prayer need during this time. The next part of the Our Father template says, "And forgive us our debts as we also have forgiven our debtors." So we can pray remembering these verses, which give us a promise that God will forgive us of our sins. 1 John 1 verses 8 to 9 says, "If we claim we have no sin, we are only fooling ourselves and not living in the truth. But if we confess our sins to him, he is faithful and just to forgive us our sins and to cleanse us from all wickedness." So Hebrews 8 verse 12 says this, "And I will forgive their wickedness and I will never again remember their sins." And Psalms 51 verses 1 to 4 goes on to say this, "Have mercy on me, O God, because of your unfailing love, because of your great compassion, blot out the stain of my sins, wash me clean from my guilt, purify me from my sin, for I recognize my rebellion. It haunts me day and night. Against you and you alone have I sinned. I have done what is evil in your sight. You will be proved right in what you say, and your judgment against me is just." And Psalms 51 is a psalm from David when he committed adultery with Bathsheba. So this is a great psalms to study with regards to asking God for forgiveness and repenting from your sin. Now, the next part of the Our Father template says, "And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from the evil one." So as we pray for strength for God to help us to overcome the temptation, we can pray these verses. 1 Corinthians 10 verse 13 says, "No temptation has overtaken you except what is common to mankind, and God is faithful. He will not let you be tempted beyond what you can bear. But when you are tempted, he will also provide a way out so that you can endure it." Galatians 5 verse 16 also says, "So I say, walk by the Spirit and you will not gratify the desires of the flesh." And Psalms 119 verse 9 to 11 says this, "How can a young man stay on the path of purity? By living according to your word. I seek you with all my heart. Do not let me stray away from your commands. I have hidden your word in my heart that I might not sin against you." So these are all examples of how we can pray that God will lead us away from temptation and deliver us from the evil one. So again, these are examples that you can put these verses in your heart, but as you continue to meditate and read the Bible for yourself, God and the Holy Spirit will reveal verses that speak very clearly to you concerning this part of the Our Father prayer. And the last part of every prayer is thanksgiving and praise. End your prayer with praise and thanksgiving because God heard you and he will answer your prayer. And we know this because of what the Word of God says. In 1 John 5, verses 14 to 15, it says, "This is the confidence we have in approaching God, that if we ask anything according to his will, he hears us. And if we know that he hears us, whatever we ask, we know that we have what we ask of him." And Philippians 4, verse 6 to 7 says, "Do not be anxious about anything, but in every situation, by prayer and petition, with thanksgiving, present your request to God. And the peace of God, which transcends all understanding, will guard your hearts and your minds in Christ Jesus." So what we're going to do right now is I'm going to pray for you concerning having a powerful prayer life. So if you're doing anything that requires your direct attention, keep your eyes open. I'll pray and you can agree with me through saying amen. Heavenly Father, we just want to say thank you. Lord, you are wonderful. You are awesome. You are holy and powerful in all that you do. And I thank you, Lord God, for this privilege and this honor, Lord God, that we can boldly approach your throne of grace, Lord God. How wonderful you are, Lord God, in all the earth, Lord God. And I thank you, Lord God, that you've created us, oh God, for your glory and for your name's sake, Lord God. Thank you, Lord God, that you are our heavenly Father who loves us, who caused us, oh God, to be in right standing with you through the blood of our Savior and our Lord Jesus Christ, Lord God. So I thank you and I ask for mercies right now for myself and every single person listening, Lord God. And I thank you that you will hear our prayer today, Lord God. And I bless you and honor you because your name is powerful, Lord God. Your name is exalted, Lord. And as I enter before your presence, I thank you that we can come before you as our and see you as our Father, our Heavenly Father who loves us, cares for us, and wants us to grow and mature in everything that you've called us to do, Lord God. So I thank you right now, and I pray for every single person listening, Lord God, that you, oh God, through the power of your Holy Spirit, oh God, will help us to order our days, Lord God, so that we may spend time meditating and reading your word, oh God, and fellowshipping with you, Lord God, so that your word will be implanted on our hearts, oh God, so that we will not sin against you, so that we will know you more, Lord God, and draw closer to you, Father God. And I pray that your Holy Spirit, Lord God, will be able to speak through us when we pray, oh God, that we will be able to pray powerfully, oh God, and pray exactly what is on your heart, Lord God. So I thank you, Lord God, that you're faithful, Lord God. May your will be done in our lives, Lord God, and may your kingdom come, Lord God, because your word says that you can do all things and no purpose of yours can ever be stopped, Lord God. So I pray, oh God, for every single person, and I ask, oh God, that you will strengthen them, encourage them, oh God, and build them up, oh God, so that their prayers are powerful, oh God, and that it brings forth fruit for your name's sake and for your glory, Lord God. And we thank you for this, Lord God. You do whatever you please, Lord God, in heavens and on the earth, Lord God. And may you have your will accomplished in all of our lives, Lord God, because we know that you are faithful, Lord God. You can work everything out for our good because we love you and you have called us according to your purposes, Lord. So we thank you today, Lord God. And if there is any need, oh God, represented here from anyone listening right now, I thank you that you will grant us the desires of our hearts, Lord God, as you say in Psalms 37, verse 4 and 5, Lord God, and we will delight ourselves in you first, Lord God. So we thank you for this, Lord, and we commit our ways and everything we do to you, and we trust you, Lord God. We continue to ask you, O God, and believe by faith that it is done, Lord God. So have your way, O God. Be glorified. We thank you, Lord God, because you have made us powerful, O God, in the image and likeness of Christ Jesus, O God, and we have dominion and power on this earth, Lord God. So we thank you for all that you have done in us and through us, O God, and we expect to see, O God, the answer to our prayer, Lord God. We expect our prayer life to be strengthened, O God, and to continue, Lord God, to move from level to level and from glory to glory, Lord God. So, O God, let the peace of God rest in our hearts, O God, as we continue to study, as we continue to learn and grow and fellowship with you and walk with you daily, Lord God. Thank you for this, Lord. Thank you for this wonderful relationship that we have with you in Christ Jesus. And we commit all that we are and have into your watchful hands, Lord God. Thank you for hearing our prayer today. In Jesus' name, we thank you and we pray. Amen. So that's it for another episode of the Faith Fight Podcast, and I hope that you were blessed by this episode. And if you were blessed, you can go over to the Faith Fight Podcast on Apple Podcasts, and you can subscribe there. You can leave a 5-star review and even write your testimony of how this podcast blessed you. And for those of you who have Android phones, you can subscribe and listen to the podcast on Google Podcasts, Spotify, Amazon Music, and on Audible. All you need to do is just search the Faith Fight Podcast. And I've recently uploaded the podcast to YouTube. So if you listen to podcasts on YouTube, you can listen to this podcast as well. And remember, I have Christian t-shirts that you can buy. The link is in the description. And the proceeds from that help fund the podcast to keep it going for many, many more years to come. And if you are a minister of the gospel, if you preach on a Sunday, or if you teach on a Wednesday, or whatever the case is, and if you want to create a podcast for your messages, reach out to me so that we can work together, so that we can help your message reach the masses and reach the ends of the earth for the glory of God, as it says in His Word. So the only other thing that I want to say is to share this episode with someone else, and remember to put on the full armor of Christ Jesus every single day and go out and fight the good fight of faith. And you'll hear from me again next week on the Faith Fight Podcast. Something good is going to happen to you today. Be blessed, everyone.